Hello, this is David from Tech Advisor. We've been sent the new 8-core iMac from Apple and we're going to take a look. So this is a very powerful machine we've been sent by Apple. It's 8 cores, as I said. It's got 16 gigabytes of RAM. It's got an SSD, half terabyte SSD. So it costs about £3,200, about $3,300 as spec. It's a build to order version. So we're going to have a little look at it. We're going to unbox it now. And then afterwards, we're going to set it up and benchmark it to see how it compares to the iMac Pro and see if it's as powerful as people say. So let's get started. Let's open up this box. And we'll start up here. See what's inside. So we think it's going to come forward. And there it is. Opening an Apple product is always a pleasure. But this is a particularly large Apple product. Let's see. Oh. Right. I don't know where I can put this. What's in here? Open up again. Ah, classic Apple tab. We can bring this forward. Now, this is the 2019 model, which Apple announced in March. And it, the first time it had updated the iMac in about 21 months. So the last version was from 2017. And this is the same externally. Oh, that's a horrible noise. Aha. Got the keyboard there. We'll deal with that in a moment. What's this? This is ridiculous. Wow. Oh. There we go. This is actually quite hard work. So I lift this out of here. Nowhere to put all these boxes. Right. Here it is. That was actually genuinely quite hard work. It's the new iMac. It's got this protective cover over it. And once we look in there, you will see that it is, as I said, essentially the same design as in 2017. Oh, there's bits of polystyrene everywhere. And there's another bit of plastic on top of this. So that design, yeah, as I said, it's the same as in 2017. It actually goes back further than that. This design with the slimmed down sides is from about 2012. And Apple's been doing this approximate design since even earlier than that. So a lot of people are saying that they should update the design in some way. There was a prediction by Ming-Chi Kuo, the analyst, who said that the display would be updated. But that is the same. There's no sign of a touchscreen, for example. Some people thought that the chin was going to get smaller as well, that it would become more of a all-screen device. But it's not, it's the same. What has changed is on the inside. So essentially the processors have been updated and the graphics have been updated. So it now gets the 8th and the 9th generation Intel processors. So this has got the 9th generation i9 with 8 cores, which is the maximum you can get. The lowest you'll get now is 6. So you'll either get 6 or 8, and previously the maximum was 4. Right, what should we look at next? There's a few more bits of plastic protecting all the shiny aluminium parts. Around here, another little bit. Should we look at the ports around the back? This is another area where it is the same as before. You've got your 4 USB ports, you've got Thunderbolt, you've got an SD card slot, you've got the power port, and here is the power supply, which is, in our case, supplied with a UK plug. That's just what UK plugs look like. Don't be alarmed if you're an American viewer. And that there. We've got a keyboard with it, which should match the same design. This is all silver, rather. You cannot get it in space grey. Space grey is the iMac Pro option. Let's open this up. We've got the magic mouse as well. And the Apple keyboard, which is a bit of a opinion divider. I think it's quite a nice design. Put these away. You get a lot of stuff with this. Here is, all right, you get the lightning, USB to lightning cable, so you can connect to your iDevices. The black lightning cable that came with the iMac Pro was weirdly popular, so you don't get that, which is a shame, but I'm sure you'll be able to get hold of one of those if you want. And lastly, you've got Apple's usual box of legal information, and normally you get a sticker. I'm sure there'll be a sticker in there somewhere. Yeah, you get a couple of stickers with the Apple logo on, and this, I think, is a screen wipe. Yes, there you go, so you can look after the screen. The screen, as I said, same specs as previously. It's a 5K screen, so it's very nice, very good colour range, very bright. But that hasn't changed. The only things that have changed are the specs. And to put those to the test, we're going to do a series of benchmarks, and we'll get back to you in a moment with the results of those. Welcome back. The benchmarking is finished, the numbers are in, and the iMac Pro is really fast. We'll get onto the numbers in a minute, but before we do, a quick reminder that this is the 8-core version of the iMac with 16 gigabytes of RAM and a half terabyte SSD. So if you buy one of the standard configurations of the iMac, it won't be quite as fast as this. This was a build-to-order version which cost about £3,200 or about $3,400. Obviously, we didn't pay that. We got it from Apple. But if you want to get one for yourself, that's how much it will cost. So on to the numbers. We started with the Geekbench 4 processing speed test. And in this, the iMac scored 6,343 in the single core section and 32,879 points in the multi-core. And that's really, really fast, although the iMac Pro with 10 cores scored slightly higher. That got 5,199 and 33,638. But this is still serious speed we're talking about. We next tested the iMac's processor in the Cinebench R20 benchmark. In this, the iMac scored 4,191 points. Those are essentially arbitrary points. But for comparison purposes, that was 52% faster than the top spec Mac Mini and 76% faster than the current best MacBook Pro. Again, the 10-core iMac Pro was a little bit faster, which scored 5,040, which is 25% faster. We tested graphics performance using our own Cinema 4D benchmark, which is based on the ProRender engine. Scores here are in seconds, and the lower the better. And the iMac 2019 scored 198 seconds, which is very, very fast compared to the MacBook Pro, for example, which scored 669 seconds, and the Mac Mini, which scored 2,101 seconds. Finally, we tested overall performance in design and art applications by using a custom Photoshop benchmark. Here, the iMac 2019 scored 920.8, which was by far the fastest performer that we tested, including the outrageously expensive HP Z8 G4 workstation. The Mac Mini scored 847.4, the MacBook Pro scored 733.6, and the Z8 G4 we just mentioned scored 725.2, making the iMac a standout performer. So the early impressions are great, the numbers look amazing, this is clearly a very, very powerful and serious machine. We cannot wait to get started on a proper review, and you'll be able to catch that on macworld.co.uk. Yeah.